Today I am very sad. You ask me, why bro, why you are sad? Then I will tell you, see my previous video. In my previous video, I was shouting that please comment in my video. But you are heartless, shameless people, don't comment in my video. That hurts me very much. Because you did not commented in my video. I say you, please comment. But you did not. You say, who cares about you? Who the hell are you? Okay, I accepted it. Please comment in this video. I know you people again don't comment in my video. But whatever, I will make more videos for you and ask you for like and comment and also for subscriber, because I am shameless. So go to the video and see what is this today's topic. So hey guys, welcome to my channel, and in today's video I am going to redesign the one of the famous JavaScript library that is called React. You say React? You are going to React in this video? No man, this is the library name. Library is basically, it is a JavaScript library. So I am going to use in this video the Figma software. In previous video I tell you that I will teach you what the Figma software is and how to design in the Figma software. In this video I am going to redesign the JavaScript famous library that is React. This website homepage, I think it's not looking so much cool, that's why I am going to redesign it and going to teach you how to use Figma. So let's go to the window screen and learn something crazy design. Hello everyone, so let's go to the window screen and start the React design. So here you can see, this is the official React website. I am going to redesign this website. You can see this is the official React website. I think it's not looking too much exciting, that's why I am going to redesign the official React website. And one more thing I want to share with you, that this React website is built by the your famous social media platform Facebook. Yes, social media platform Facebook has built this React website and the React library. So let's go to the Figma and start the design. Here you can see, this is the Figma. Here you can design your anything, any kind of work you can design here. Here you can see, this is the platform. I am logged in, that's why it is showing me that I am logged in here. Here you can see the logout. If you want to log out from the website, you can click the logout button and you can go to the logout, and then you can start the new design. Here is the one section that is plugin. If you want to download any types of plugins, plugin means it is the helping hand for any designer. So if you want to use the plugins, you can use it. Here you can get desktop app. If you want to download it in your desktop, in your laptop, then you can download it through there. I don't want to download it. I want to use it in the browser. That's why I am going to use it here. So here is the setting option. In the setting option, you can change your name, you can change your mail ID, you can change your password. Or if you want to be the Figma upgraded plan, if you want to take the Figma upgrade plan, then you can take it from there. So let's go to the here's the option that is the new. If you we want to create a new design, that's why we click here, and here you can see that is the design file. If you click here, you will go to this kind of page. I have previously opened this page, that's why I am not doing it. Here you can see one of the section that is called frame. If you hit on it, here you can see there are a lot of options like phone, tablet, desktop, MacBook Pro, Surface Pro, iPad, anything. If you want to design for MacBook, then you select MacBook. If you want to design for desktop, then you select desktop. But I am going to design for desktop, that's why I selected this option. So here you can, if I select this option, you can see this kind of surface will come up. Here you can see this page is totally white, but I want to put something here. Here you can see there are a lot of options. Here is the one is rectangle, one is line, one is arrow, one is decrease, polygon, stars. Or if you want to place any kind of background image, then you can put it from there. But I am going to use a rectangle kind of stuff. here I am hit the rectangle. Here you can see this is the plus icon shows up. That means you can create any type of rectangle now. If I drag it down, then you can see it create a rectangle for me. So if you want to rotate it, come here. Here you can see this is the arrow sign. That means you can rotate it now. If I press on the mouse, or if you on the phone, then press the phone screen and then drag it. Then you can see it is started rotating it, and you can fit it anywhere. That you can look like cool. That I want to drag it down. Here you can see this is the look like that. I want to look like that. Half portion will be, if half portion is covered and half portion is white, I want to change the color of the rectangle. So can change the color. So select it. Yeah, select. After selecting, here you can see there are a lot of sections in the side here. This is the radius section. If you want to give any kind of radius, then you use it. So I will call you. Here you can see now I am going to reduce the size to show you that how you can change the radius of the rectangle. Here you can see that the now they have the sharp corner, but I want to the rounded corner. That's why I select it. If I put and drag it here you can see it is going to started rounding. It started rounding. Here you can see that the height of the corner is started rounding. How much you want to round, you can put it here. That I want to round like 50. Then you can see it is the 50 round will come up. So that's are all kind of basic things, all kind of basic things about the rectangle, how to use it. Here you can see the background color is kind of gray. If you want to change the color of the background, here is the option. Click it. Here you can see the color palette will come up. You can choose any of the color if what you want to give it. So you can choose it from there. That way you can click. Okay, so I am going to remove this. Click delete option. It will be deleted. Previously I have set up that. So here I am using a polygon. Okay, here I am using a polygon. Polygon I previously selected it. So here you can see this is the polygon. So I hide it here with the eye option. If I click it, you can see the eye is token. If I hit it on again, then you can see the section will go down. So that's why you can create. Here I am using the polygon section. You can see this is the polygon I am using. So I fit it like that. It look like this. I fit it this way. That's why it look like this. Okay, that's why it look like this. Now I want to put the React logo. So I go to the browser and search the React logo. Here you can see there are a lot of React logo. You can download it from there. I already downloaded it and I also put it here. Here you can see the, that is the, here you can see this React logo I previously downloaded and put it here. And one more thing, how I put the React logo from my file. So go here, click there, and here you can see this is the file section. If I hit on the place image, it will go you to the all kind of drives, that C drive, D drive, download, what you download. You can select any kind of images from there and click the open button. And if you click the open button, this image will come up here. Then you change the size of the image and put it where you want to place. So I place it here. You can place anywhere, but in this design I am going to redesign this kind of website. Here you can see the React logo is the left side of the page. That's why I put it here in the left side of the page. And then we are going to create the Nampa section. In the Nampa section, there you can see this is the Docs, Utility, Docs, Community, Search Bar, Languages, GitHub, and what version of the React is, everything is here. So that kind of text I have to put it here. So how can I put the text? So for place the text in this page, here you can see this is the T kind of logo. If I hit on it, here you can see the text option. If you hit on it, you can put any kind of text here. So that way you can create any kind of text. So I already put those text. So I am going to be visible those text in this page. So I hit on the eye icon. Here you can see I already placed those things. So Docs, Tutorials, Blog, Community, all kind of things I have placed here. Now here you can see there is one more section, that is search section. So I want to create a search bar. That's why I choose the rectangle and choose the rectangle. If I tell you that if you want to give a kind of round kind of corner, then you will go up here and change it. Here you can see it is started rounding this rectangle. So this way you can create the rounded rectangle. So I already created the rounded rectangle. Here you can see the rectangle is going in the blue kind of stuff. If I hit on the eye icon, here you can see this is the start bar. One more thing, here you can see this is the search, this is the search text. Here I have to put that this is the search text. Here you can see they are also using the search, so that's why search text. So I have to put it here that this is the search page, so that's why I have to write it down that this is the search page. By hitting the I icon, here you can see the search is automatically come up. Actually, I have created the search, so that's why I go to the text icon, and here you can I have typed FEARCH search. Now, if I drag it down and put it here, you can see you cannot see the search because the color of the search is now. So change the color of the brush. If I red, blue, white, or whatever you want to put, you can put it here. So that's why you can see it. Okay, I am going to delete it because already I have created the search text. Now I want to put one more thing, that is the GitHub section, language section, and the person section. But I am using the GitHub language and the one of the logo, that is one of the logo, that is Twitter. I am going to use the Twitter section here. How I grab those kind of logos for those logos, you go there, you can see there is one section that is plugin. I am going to use the icon, so that's why one section that is called icon. If you click on it, here you can see there are lots of icons present here. You can search what type of icon do you want. Here you can see this is the GitHub website, but I don't want this kind of stuff. That's why I created this kind of logo. Actually I searched this from the Google and change the background using Photoshop and then put it here. Here you can see that the background is totally removed, only the logo is present here. Now I want to place a text here. So for place a text, I want the want this kind of text, that this is React and JavaScript library to reading from for user. This kind of text I want to put. So go here and here's the text section and create a text that this is REACT React, and I want to change the color. I want to change this kind of color, okay? And I also want to change the color. Here you can see you can bold, black, italic, black. What kind of style you want to change, you can change it from there. I want a bold kind of stuff, and I want to change the color from white to blue, okay? Now I want to change the size of the 72, but it's not look so much good. I want 144. I think it's now perfect. So now drag it where you want to put it. I want to put it here, and I change the font. I think this font is not looking good. Poppins, one of the fonts that is called Poppins. I am going to use this. So where is the Poppins? Here you can see this is the Poppins. I want to use this kind of stuff, and I change this to bold. Poppins, change this to bold. Here you can see this is changed now. I want extra bold. No, it's not look good. Change it to semi bold. Now it look like good. And change the color. This kind of color is not matching. Okay, it looks good. Okay, I put it here and I want to change something. I give a effect here. I add a drop shadow. Background block, no, it's not look good. Now shadow, no, drop shadow, I think it looks cool. And add the drop shadow. Here you can see after when I add the drop shadow, it started looking so much attractive now. Now I want to push this kind of thing, that was left from reading in the video. So come up here and then hit on the paste button and hit here again and paste it. I want to change the size. Want to change the size 144 to 48. Here you can see the text size is changed. So now drag it here, and I want to change it to small. Okay, now it looks perfect and looking killer. Here you can see it's now looking killer. Okay, so that was fine. I think some kind of drop shadow I can add it here. So come up here and use effect. This kind of drop shadow is not looking good. Now it looks perfect. Here you can see it looks killing. Okay, so this is the page. Now I want to add, here you can see they are using some that gives take a new tutorial. So what we can do now, we go here and then put a box here like this way, that is get started now. So change the color here. I want this color. No, I think this color is look more good. No, what is the color? Okay, So I change the color. Now input the date. Get started. Get started. Here you can see I put it here. Get started here. Now it looks something interesting. Okay. Now it's dead. Now I want to give some kind of rounded shape. That's why I come up here and change it. And see, I give some kind of rounded shape. Now it looks cool. One more thing I want to add, that is take a tube tutorial. I have to put it here, that take a tube tutorial. So put the text here that tutorial. So change the color black to this kind of color. I think it looks cool. And change the size 36 to 48. Okay. And this is here. Now I want a arrow. So come up here. Here you can see this is the arrow section. Drag it. Put it here. And change the size. And change the color also. What is the color you want? 48. So come up here and change the color. It looks perfect. Here you can see now it looks perfect and so much attractive looking. This is the first page. This is the first page we have designed, and then in the next section here you can see this kind of stuff. We want to put it in one more. We are going to create one more texture frame. So hit on the frame. Here you can see texture section. It is there. Now we are going to create one more section. Create one more section. That is this kind of. We are going to select this kind of case we want to put. So go here. We want to create a rectangle. So come up here and choose a rectangle and put it here. Put it here. So what? There are three faces: declarative, comparative, and alarm. So we are going to create key phases. So at one, copy it. How I copy it? Actually, I press the alt and press the mouse key and drag it. Then I have created. That's why I created this kind of stuff. Yeah. Now it looks cool. I want to put those steps. Before I put those steps, I want to change the color of this palette. What kind of color I can choose? What kind of color is going to copy it and put all the every boxes based on the color code. Here you can see it's totally changed now. Now I zoom it little bit. Here you can see there are three boxes come up. I want to put those text here. First the heading section, declarative, copy it to the text section, paste it here, and now drag it to the mid section. And one more thing, that is component based. Copy it and come up here, and I want to put it here. So put the text and paste it here. So copy those text. I copied those text, and now I'm going to put it here. Change the size to 10. Now put it here. Drag it down change the color to 10, change the size to 10 to 13. No, 13 is smaller, 14. Okay, I think 14 is looking very okay. 18 is too much, so 14 is okay. I think the 15 will be more okay. Yes, it looks nice now. Okay. So now I want to put this section. Here you can see there is a bold type of text and this kind of text, and here you can see this is the code editor we are using. So I create this also. So let's go to the screen. So here I have to put this kind of text. I have to put this kind of text. So how I can do this? So come up here and choose the text section and change the size to 15 to 24. And now I want to put this text, that text simple component. Copy this and put it here. Okay, I put it here. Now I change the color to blue. Color to blue, and I also want to add this kind of thing. Copy this, create a text box. I created this. Now I have to create this kind of box. Box not. It is code editor. I told it box. Okay. Create the box. That is code editor. And put it here. Change the color to bluish kind of stuff. Now put the code. What is write it here. Copy it. No, sorry. One more thing. Like CSS. I have to put it here. One more thing. That is one. Now create a text. Now create a text that I want to put. What is here? Like JSF reader. Copy it. Like JSF reader. Put it here and create this kind of stuff. JSF. So come up here. Click it on the text button and type JSF. Now I want to put the code, what is greater, I select the code and copy it and come here and select the text section and paste it here. And I want to change the size to 18 to 15. Now I put the all the code up here. You can see it looks like this way now. And one more thing, I have to show the output in the screen. That's why I create one more rectangle kind of box and change the color to gray and select the text section, put it here. And get the result and change it to 3 volt to volt. Now put it here, change the size 15 to 18. Now I put the what is the result that I will get, copy it, and I want to put it here to select the rectangle, and this is the output that I want to show. So put it here, one more thing, and create here one type of rectangle, change the color to darker blue and change the size. Now it will create result half. Let me see. I get it, okay? Yep. Come up here. Again, take it. Here you can see, now it is changed. So, now I want to put the... Now I want to... create this. The section, here you can see this kind of the section I want to create. So come up here and मेरे को नहीं, आई हैव क्रिएटेड द टूटा किसान ऑटो, नाउ यू कम अप हियर एंड चेंज द नेम टू अनटाइटल्ड टू रिएक्ट वेबसाइट. मेरे को नहीं, नाउ द पेज, ओके फाइन, टू चेंज द नेम अगेन. Yeah, website. It is now saved. Save it. So here you can play it or check if it is looking good or not. So that's it, guys. This is the today's video, and I have designed the full React website using the Figma software. If hope all of you like this, if you like this, please hit the like button and smash the subscribe button also. And that's it. So bye for today.